Hey, what's going on, guys and gals? Welcome back to Mindcrack. Wow, two episodes in a row. Did one yesterday, doing one today. Imagine that. By the way, we're in Vex's hidden lair, and I just went through my secret door. Of course, I, as a neighbor, have a back door entry and a key, of course, to get in. And I've just noticed that he's got this lovely white and pink carpet. I know he's been hanging out with Aurelian a lot, and I'm wondering if maybe she's rubbed off on him a bit. Now, I shouldn't stereotype. I shouldn't say just because she's a girl. Oh, booger? Vex has a booger? Aw, oh, man, I want a booger. Booger Fleming, is that you? Escape from the stronghold from Paul Plays Minecraft? Actually, I broke him out, didn't I? Anyway, I love terrariums. Terrariums are so cool. I'm going to have a terrarium on the new map. So yeah, I'm just wondering what happened here. He had pink. Vex strikes me as a guy with red or black. Not pink. But whatever. Whatevs. So anyway, I am just waiting for Guude to get on the server. We're gonna make my statue for the UHC monument, even though I don't ever play because they record at hours where I am unable to play, like on weekends. However, wrong thing. I just wanted to give this back to Vex. It's his boat. Howdy neighbor boat. This is Vex's boat. Howdy, let's call it the Howdy neighbor boat. We'll just call it Howdy neighbor, because you know how boats have names, right? We're going to call this the Howdy neighbor craft. Howdy neighbor. That's the boat. That's the name of the boat. And I'm giving it back now. Let's do a sign. I should always carry around signs. I love leaving signs. Signs. Alright, now let's put it somewhere pretty obvious. And, oh, jeepers, crow. I'm going to have to make either a frame or a chest. How about... Well, I don't have any leather. Does Vex have any leather? Chest it is! Oh! Hold on. Chest it may not be. I'm thinking it's over here with the animal stuff. Egads! Take some of those. I might need those. I'm not sure if we're going to be doing the build in creative mode. I hope so. I can't build in survival mode, especially while doing commentary. I'm terrible at building, so I hope Goods puts me into creative. Where's all your leather? I could borrow some chickens, too, while I'm at it. Probably looking at frames and don't even know it. Well, let's do this. Let's grab one of these guys. In fact, because what I'd like to do, is make a jack-o'-lantern. This is appropriate. I'm just going to make a chest. I don't have time to do the other thing. I should probably go see if Guude's on Skype right now, in fact. But okay, quickly! I'm on Do Not Disturb, so if he's buzzing me, I cannot hear him. Now, I don't know if he's going to get this. And if you happen to see him, please tell him what's here. This is his. And howdy neighbor boat. He left it at my house. You left this in my bay. Not my house. You left this in my bay. PSJ. And let's put a howdy neighbor dude. It's just going to be a head. Well, let's... Oh, boy. I want to make him double high. Double high. It's a double high neighbor. I don't have any arms for him. Just kind of a shame. But let's just put him back here. And we'll put a face on him because that was kind of the funny thing. Can I not put that on there? Oh, that's stinky rotten. So what we'll do is put this here and oops. Okay. Boy, I bet you guys just can't wait to see me make this build. Huh. I can't even put a pumpkin on top of a block, for gosh sake. There we go. Where there's a will, there's a way, my friends. And I should probably... We get some arms while we're here. Does he have any cobble? Make a lever. How do you make a lever? Yeah, I do that. I'm not sure if you put levers on fences either, so what we'll do is this. Howdy, neighbor! That's good enough. Okay, coup dat. Televex. Okay? Televex, this is here waiting for him. Howdy, neighbor boat. And now I must away. Whew. Like a thief in the night. Just like our SWAT mission. Goodbye. Dun, 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 dun. And this is going to bug the heck out of him. Watch. Yeah, let's just do this. Let's see how that bugs him. That'll bug him. He'll figure that out in a jiff. Perfect. Okay. I'll see you guys at the statue build.
Hello, guys! We're back with more statue building today. Paul has joined me.
Hello!
Yay!
Yay! Statue building, huh?
Yeah. You're really good at this, aren't you?
You build
plans for all your statues.
You build, I watch, right? Is this my seat over here? Okay, good. You go, bro. No, I've never built a statue in Minecraft ever, and I'm proud of it.
Well,
but I'm ready, man.
At least these aren't like the little pixel statues, right?
So. These are awesome. I love this. Yeah, I like these caricatures.
Yeah,
kind of the 3D going on there. Yep.
You're gonna be great, I think.
But you know what, though? Yeah, well, you pulled a fast one on me because I had all the math written down on a piece of paper. And all the dimensions, pixel by pixel. Like, I'm gonna nail this down. So now you screwed me up. Curveball.
Well, I'm looking at your skin here, and I think you have great feet, so I'm going to start with those. And the last three I've built, we messed it completely up, and everyone online is really mad at me, so we're not going to mess you up.
Don't mess me up. Yeah, you can mess me up.
Yeah, I made the BTC way too tall. He's like 2 blocks too tall. You can't tell it when you look at it from here, but he's way too tall. And then next is your legs.
So are there any specific dimensions that we're going with?
Okay,
or anything?
There are. It is 4 until the crotch. So we got 1 right now. And then it's 2 for the waist, and then 5 for the torso, and 9 for the head.
Okay.
So those are the numbers.
Okay, so we're going up 3 with the legs?
Right, 3 more.
And I have to make sure I get the colors right here. I know you gave me a bunch of colors to work with.
Yeah, that's the thing. You got to kind of pick
and choose. So I need browns for the leggies.
Right.
Okay. And I have some kind of knee pad thing.
Yeah, you do. I don't know how you're going to work that one in. You've got 4 blocks. Work it out.
I'm working it out. Let's do it. How would
They're kind of... What color is that? It's kind of like a dark green or
that's
something.
That's a brown.
Well, no, yeah, that... But I meant the knee pad.
Oh, the knee pads are like a gray or something.
Gray,
I can't see. You know, let me take off my armor.
What if what if you did it like this? You have the brown there, and then knee pad, and then...
There you go.
Brown.
Those aren't tough skins. Those are going to wear out fast. Just saying.
So, normally we talk about how you got on the server, but we're both old men. I don't think either of us remember.
Oh, man. It goes way back, yeah. Back to 2011.
Yeah, right? We met at the first Minecon.
Do you have any of that gray wool? Toss it down here.
Yeah. Here you go. I guess I didn't share everything with you today.
Nope.
I went at that after.
There we go.
So does that look good for the knee pads, or should it go all the way across, you think?
No, it's only on the inside, I think.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Like, according to my dimensions,
yeah.
it was much bigger, but I think two works.
All right. I don't have any ladders. I need ladders for us to climb you.
Now, I thought we were going to do this in creative mode. I'm like, I couldn't possibly do this in survival mode. Oh, my God.
Yeah, I know, right? We should have a creative server. I think everyone would just play there, though.
I think it'd be fun. Yeah, once in a while. Once in a while.
Just have, like, a creative section of our server where we just all go every once in a while and just build stuff.
I could practice there.
Yeah. Oh, hey, man, the UAC monument would be there next season.
Yeah,
if we had a creative section. Okay, I don't have any ladders. We're just going to have to use dirt to climb up. I'm going to have to ladders.
I've got some wood.
Okay. Make us some ladders, I guess.
Make us some ladders.
Oh, we were all prepared.
Do I have wood? I have wood.
I don't see any wood anywhere.
I don't have any wood. Oh, I have 18. Okay, 18. That's not much.
I don't know what it takes to make ladders. I've had... Oh, here we go. Here's the ladders. I found the ladders.
Oh, you found them?
Yes. Yep.
Got lots of them? Well, I'll make some anyway.
19. I don't know if it's enough to go all the whole body.
All right, I've got 18.
Yeah, that'll be plenty then. And all right, so then we have two for the waist four. Here. While you're making ladders, I'll go ahead and put your belt on, because that's basically the waist.
Okay.
Like I said, it's gray. So, how'd you get... I guess, let's start with how you got into Minecraft, because that's almost the same, like, the story of how we met, is because that was right before the first Minecon.
Yeah.
Or, well, about a year before the first Minecon, I guess.
Well,
you were one of the first YouTubers, basically.
Yeah, I mean, I started back in 2000 and, let's see, Minecon was 2011, so it would have been 2010.
Yep.
So 2010, somewhere in the summer, I had found the game on a forum that I normally go to, all about gaming. And I remember they're talking about it and how it's survival and there's, you know, zombies and you have to, you have to live out in the woods and so forth and so on. So I know it was very early when the game first came out, so there wasn't really a heck of a lot in it. So anyway, yeah. I saw some screenshots of it and I decided, well, let me give this a shot. And I downloaded it from the website. I think it was like $10 at the time, and started playing. And I fell in love immediately. It's just right. It was right up my alley. The whole survival bit, you know, the sandboxy thing. So if you want to hand me some blocks, I'm terrible at building and talking at the same time. So you can build. Don't stop. Don't wait for me.
Okay. That's our skid right there. Skid tone. So I'm going to put your hands on
so
the hands.
The arms are going to be out
over here, like one
are
down.
Are you going down any? Okay.
Yeah. Like right where the waist right there. Yeah.
Gotcha. I mean, you're cranking out here, and I'm like, oh, geez.
Yeah, you know what?
Guy.
I've built so many of these
done
at this
so
point.
Many
I'm just, things. It's like muscle memory. There's like okay. a little, there's a hole. Okay, hold on. You didn't have this quite right. It's, you got like a, it's almost like an action, you know, like for your, like your kids. You got the little hole for the sword.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
So you got that, basically.
Like
and then
Lego.
It comes back
it's a Lego
in.
Hand.
Yeah, like, exactly. Lego hand. There you go.
Beauty.
And then it comes back in.
So anyway, yeah, so I ended up finding it, and there was not a lot of documentation, obviously, because it was, like, pretty brand spanking new. It was early alpha. So right. I was kind of confused on how to play, and I ended up looking around for some information, maybe a video or whatever. I'm just going to copy you, if that's okay.
Okay, yeah, it's five up.
Okay. Is that five? One, two, three, four, and five. Did I lose you?
We're back.
Okay, we're back. Building. A little bit.
Without me losing the internet.
Okay, I think I went five up. One, two, three, four, five. I guess I went one extra. So, I was saying, anyway, to make a long story short, because I tend to drag this on, but so I made my first video. It was my first YouTube video ever, in fact. It was the How to Survive Your First Night in Minecraft. So I put that up and went out on vacation. Went up to Canada, in fact. Up to Niagara Falls, and I had my iPhone with me, and all of a sudden I was getting all these notifications from YouTube. You know, this little thing every time I got an email notification from YouTube
right.
that you know, someone had subscribed to me. Or I think I even had it set to views, like so every view or something like that.
Oh wow!
Yeah, it was crazy. So I'm like, what the heck's going on with my phone? And then I realized it was because of that particular video. So things started to take off from there.
Like that quick, like within
just a couple of days. I mean, I was up there for maybe a day, and that's when the phone started to take off. I think what happened was eventually X found my video, and then you know, David X,
who
was on Machinima. I think it was a Machinima at the time. So he picked it up, and then he started making or he made a video for a shelter or something like that. And then from there, CNanners saw his. So David's, and then CNanners made a video, and then from that point on, it just, you know, just took off.
Right.
And that's when my channel, obviously, because I had the first tutorial anyway. There were some other videos on Minecraft there, but they were most of the like info.
Yeah.
So that, you know, I got lucky. It was just good timing, essentially. And
do you remember what day that was? Like what day?
Yeah.
Oh,
month,
year, and all
do.
That stuff.
Of course.
Because I mean, like, yeah, July. Like my first Minecraft, October 19th, 2010. I'll never forget. You know.
You never forget your first. It was July 29th, 2010.
Yeah, I was asking.
Pretty sure
was
it was
curious,
the 29th.
Like how much time in between that and whenever I did? Because I saw CNanners and one of his videos, and I I just, you know, that was what inspired me to make my first video. Well, one of the things, yeah.
So like, I'm sure a lot of people saw his for the first time and came on board. And X too. I think at the time X probably had like 50,000 subscribers, which was a lot for a gaming channel.
Right. I remember watching.
It's
X's
still a
series.
Lot, but back then, I mean, he's, you know, he was one of the premier.
Right.
And you're doing a fine job here, by the way, Guude.
Yeah. No, I got you. Don't you worry.
I got moral support.
I got it. We're gonna have a statue here. I will build it.
I can put my
stead side.
Man, I am impressed. I gotta tell you, you're just banging this thing out. So. Now let me do something. Let me put my cuffs on at least. Do I like shoulder pads or something?
Well, here's where the head goes.
Oh, I'm trying to put a block down and you're in the way.
No,
that's
fine.
No, the one block.
No blocks.
I see how it is.
This is actually where your head starts. You kind of have like scruff though. So I was thinking like for the scruff, it would be like this color right here.
That's purple.
We don't have a light. It's
dang.
Well, not purple. It may look purple.
it's not.
There
we go. That's not purple. That's
yeah.
That's 5 o'clock shadow color. That's the name of that block right there. 5 o'clock shadow.
This game would be that. Like the actual
okay,
skin.
So I can put my face on it.
Yeah.
Let me see if I have some of that. So that looks like light gray. Yeah. There we go.
It is. Yes.
Right. So I'll put my chin on.
Right. Yeah, I'm just gonna let you. I will watch you now.
Oh, jeez, pressure's on. Man. How big is my jowl? Jeepers.
It comes all the way to right jowl. Here. Yeah, it comes back in right here.
Okay. There we go.
And then it goes on the back. I'll put the actual skin color on the back, unless you have 5 o'clock shadow in the back of your head. Too.
I do shave the back of my head. I shave my whole head now. Actually, I got the whole. I'm doing the whole Zisto thing. Yeah.
When did you start doing that? Is it because you're going
last
bald?
Summer.
I was getting thin. I'm going bald.
Well, getting back to that, where I met you at, MindCon in 2011, right? I mean, that's where we first met. And so I, you know, my hair was thinning. I'm a lot older than most people, on Mindcrack. And do we have any black for the mouth? Oh, it's back there.
Yeah. It kind of goes in one. So do the eyes.
Well, that's cool. So last summer I did, I just decided to shave it off. I went to do the Tough Mudder up in Mount Snow, Vermont, and I'm like, "Hey, this is a good time to shave it off." So
what
I just
the
Tough Mudder is a tough. It's a roughly 10 mile obstacle course on Mount Snow. Actually, it's all over the world, and I put down 2 blocks. Amazing, and. You basically have to run it or jog it or hike it. And on the mountain, you have to hike, essentially. And then there's like 25 different obstacles, like climbing and crawling through mud and barbed wire and electrical fences and all kinds of crazy crap.
Did you do all of it?
I did the entire thing, twice. Not the same time.
Twice?
Well, I did it two years ago, and then I did it last year, too. And I was going to do it this summer, but I'm bringing my son to college at the same weekend. So.
Did you do it with you? The whole 10 miles?
Oh, no. You have to be 18 to do it. So I did it with a neighbor and a couple of guy friends that live nearby.
Wow, you're so much more of an alpha male than I am.
We're going to get you to do it. They're all over the world. They are everywhere. And you know, I don't recommend starting with a Tough Mudder, but I mean, there's some other ones like the Mud Runs, the Spartan Runs, stuff like that. They're like 5 miles or 5K or something like that. It's just a lot of mud and a lot of fun.
Sounds so, I don't even know, crazy. I mean, it's not something I've done when I was younger, but now that I'm old and brittle, I don't know that I can handle it.
It's not something I was really all that interested in doing. My neighbor talked me into it.
Oh, really?
And then after the first time, like, wow, this is really cool.
Really good video.
I think I can do some hair.
Just like covered in mud. You should have recorded.
I did. I actually have one on my channel.
I've got to check it out then.
My buddy's daughter, well, she couldn't go on the whole track with us, but she did record some of it. Where the spectators were hanging out, because you could be a spectator. Oops, that didn't work out. And you can go on some of the track, but not the whole thing. So we did have some video.
Have you seen this new
am
like
in your way, Master Builder?
Yeah, you're doing great. I don't know exactly if that's the right color for your hair though. It's kind of green.
It's kind of yellow.
Yeah,
green, yellowish thing. Well, like, I have yellow. You gave me yellow blocks. You know what these are for?
Yellow. I don't know if that looks too yellow,
this
though.
This is for the pee puddle around my my feet.
Yeah.
Because I'm so afraid to build anything in Minecraft.
Oh, man. Yeah, I don't think that yellow looks right, though. It looks really... It's got to be brown, I guess.
Well, I just grabbed any old skin. I looked up, I think, like, Survivor Man or Adventure. I didn't look either. And this was one of the ones that first popped up. There weren't that many skins back then, either.
Right.
So I just snagged it. It doesn't look like me at all.
Yeah.
It's just a guy in a jacket.
So did you start wearing... Because every time you would be on the shaft, you would wear basically the hat that's on your skin. Did you go out and buy that just for...
No, what? I have boonies from all my outdoor stuff. I do kayaking, hiking, and backpacking. So I've got a couple of different styles of boonies. So that was just something I picked up and used it. So I got into the kind of the character, my man versus Minecraft character role.
So basically, everything you do in Minecraft is just stuff you do in real life. You're just doing it on a
video
game.
Yeah, and that's what attracted me to Minecraft, essentially, just the whole, you know, living outdoors. And, you know, obviously the zombies and skeletons were a little added bonus, but... yeah, you have to grow your own food. You're gonna close me in here.
Yeah,
trying to figure out where to go.
See you next season, Paul.
Hey, how come Paul's not on the new map? He's stuck in the old one.
Yeah, he's just in his head.
He's in his head. He's a legend in his own mind. Yeah. So I do. I enjoy the outdoors and living kind of a minimalist life. Trying anyway, but with three kids, that's practically impossible.
Yeah, but they're all getting to an age now. What's your youngest now?
My youngest is 12.
Oh, okay, I guess I thought they were a little older.
My oldest is
going to college. You were about to be free for the first time.
Freedom! Like, yeah, I guess. Yeah. I honestly, I mean, it's been so long, you know, as a parent. I'm looking forward to the time where we have some... where we're empty nesters. But I mean, don't get me wrong, I mean, I love my kids, and we spend a lot of time together. We do all kinds of activities, and that's one of the reasons I don't make a lot of the events that you guys do on the weekends. And it drives me crazy, because I want to do it so badly. Like, you know, getting back to how I found you guys is, I mean, I knew about you from Minecon, and we talked about Mindcrack, and of course I've seen the name everywhere as just part of the community.
Right.
That looks great. You are doing a swell job.
I'm trying to figure it out now, because you got your hat, right? And on your skin, it comes right to your eyes.
Yes, it does. It's right in my eyes.
Yeah. Like
shade my eyes right down low.
Just be here right now.
You know what, Guude? I have faith. You will figure it out.
I'm so glad that you're so helpful, Paul.
Hey, Paul, you want to help build your statue? Oh, sure.
Yeah, sounds great.
be right there. I'll bring the pina coladas.
Hey, I was probably...
All right, I'm going to mimic you on this side, I think.
Okay, yeah, I think that goes around.
So I can just
I think
go around.
The hat goes around.
It's a wide brim hat, yep.
Nope. It is really wide brim. So what were you saying, though?
So I saw, you know, I knew about Minecraft just from everyone, you know, all the guys being on it and everybody being big in the community. But I saw one of your UHCs. It was a very early UHC. When it was, you're all alone. And I think I watched your perspective, and I think I watched a little bit of B-dubs, and I forget who else. But I was like, wow, this is great. Because you know how I love the whole hardcore. I like things hard.
Right.
My gaming. And I like a survival challenge. So I thought that was perfect. And I think I even texted you. Not texted. I messaged you or something.
Yeah,
and I got in contact with you somewhere. I don't remember exactly where. I was like, this is brilliant. Oh, I know what. I think I had, I did a mod review of the UHC mod, because that was a mod back then.
Oh, yes. I remember that. Yeah, that's what
it was.
Yeah, you did do that. Yeah, you got it right.
So I did a review of the mod, and then I think we got in contact some point after that. And I'm like, this is great. I thought it was brilliant. Not only the gameplay... but also the fact that you've got multiple perspectives.
Right. Yeah, you know, I remember, because I think you asked to join a UHC before. I think how you got on Minecraft was asked. I think you asked to
play
with us.
That's what I wanted. Right. I said, if you ever need anyone, to do UHC if you're looking for a guest or something like that or anything. And I didn't come right out and say, hey, I want to be in Mindcrack, but I did. I was really interested. And you're like, yeah, cool. So, you know, this season just ended. We don't do it that often, but we'll definitely get back. And I'm like, cool. That's awesome. So I did that mod review, and I really liked it. And, you know, of course, there was some speculation about joining Mindcrack after I did the mod review. But I really didn't understand Mindcrack then. I mean, I knew what you guys were doing here, but I didn't. I'm not a multiplayer person, you know. And I thought it was pretty intriguing. But and then I think finally you asked. You said, "Hey, you wanna join UHC this weekend?" I was like, "Dang it! I was going camping.
Yeah,
I was going camping. I was camping with the kids that weekend. It was a long. I do it every year. It's just dad and kids thing. I've been doing it for probably 15 years. How's it look?" I've been working hard at this, Guude.
You look like a witch hunter or something.
That's cool.
Yeah, that's cool. It doesn't really look like you, though, I don't think. I don't know. It's good.
All right, let me check it out.
I feel like your belt buckle needs to be slightly different, almost. It's the only thing. Maybe if the belt buckle came out one block, it would... I don't know. What do you think?
I think it looks great. Honestly, I think it's awesome.
Okay.
No, it's perfect. Yeah, it does look like I have a diaper on, though. Listen, I may be old, but I'm not wearing Depends yet. That's a Depend. Now I'm going to have to go put the puddle down here. Dang you.
It looks really good. The belt buckle needs... or that. That pretty much puts it all together.
Leaky old man.
Oh, God.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Yeah, you fit right in.
Beautiful, beautiful sight.
You need ears. You need ears. There's a couple things I always forget. Ears is one of them. And okay. I always get hear about it.
What?
So you're going to be able to hear. Don't worry. Yeah.
What?
What? Can't hear you.
Man. Okay, now we just get back up there.
Yeah, you know, I always felt bad whenever you joined, though, because you joined and we all went to play Feed the Beast.
The first season, it was kind of a... I didn't really know how to play. Like I said, I wasn't really sure what to do. So, like, do we do collabs constantly? Like, I think I ran into Beef one time. I can't do this stupid letter. And Beef just kind of snuck up on me one day. I was doing my recording, and he was invisible. And I'm like, oh, this is funny. Hi, Beef. How you doing? I hadn't really talked to him any. And I said in chat, I'm like, Skype. Get on Skype. And he must have been like, what? Okay, I'm just kind of a spur of the moment thing, which is in some cases very cool, you know, the spontaneity.
Yeah.
But I just thought that's what we did. I think you did it the right way. You are a master builder. You've got the scaffolding. I'm trying to climb my freaking body with ladders. You must be like, what a dope. This guy's never built a thing in his life. So, and then Beef entertained me, and he's like, oh, hey, buddy, how you doing? And we talked for a few minutes, and then he went and did his thing, and I did mine, and then I realized later that's just not what you do, you know? You gotta schedule these things.
Yeah, we are pretty bad about... we should do more spontaneous collaborations, though, I think. I think that would be... I don't know, because every time we do it, it's really fun.
I think those are the best to be... Yeah, in my opinion, I mean, I think, obviously, schedule stuff works well when you have a plan. But I, you know, some of those for me anyway, I just like to be doing my thing and then suddenly somebody shows up. Anders was notorious for that because his schedule was very similar to mine. And I bumped into
all these like early morning. Anyone wants to know where it's noon right now. It's really for me.
Yeah. Are you in the same time zone as me?
I think so. You're East Coast, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm East Coast as well. No, I guess if I was West Coast, it'd be really early. No, this is not technically early. But I always play with these people that play until like 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning.
In the morning.
And
yeah.
So then I go to bed and get up around noon each day.
You're like my kids.
My daughter gets up around 9 right now. So she's
that's perfect.
Too.
Yeah.
So, yeah. That's but perfect. I still don't get till noon. My wife gets up with her.
Well, hopefully, yeah. Oh, nice. hopefully, with the next season, I'm just going to get a better perspective. There we go. We'll do some more collabs. I mean, I know.
Yeah.
I don't, you know, kind of the cat out of the bag with the details, but.
Are you going to be a builder this season? known for all your builds?
I actually have an idea to do something that's kind of buildy, but I'm more of a detail. Like, I can't do big builds. Like, that museum is just. I'll probably never tackle a project like that again. I mean, I loved it, but I like the interior stuff. I like the. There you go. It's bulging. It's bursting. Bursting with pride.
I thought it would look better, but it doesn't. It looks worse.
It's just like a diaper.
Diaper is full now, Paul.
That's perfect. That is great.
That's why it's leaking, I guess.
It's filmed and now it's coming out the sides. At least it's the yellow stuff. Could be worse.
I'm not taking it away.
No. It's got to stay.
I mean, the yellow's staying too, I guess. So.
Yeah. Yep.
It's your statue. That's how you want it.
I like it.
Forever will be remembered as the old man that peed himself.
And he knew he had to make a statue. Nothing scares me, but building statues does.
Oh, God. You got to make another UHC, actually. People have been asking it. HUHC. Where's Paul? We got to get you there. It's a weekend thing, though, and that's the worst time for you, right?
We're never home on weekends. I've got three kids all involved in various things, and we're always out in the weekends.
Yeah.
And I did actually make it to one, and it was like a 3 or 4 hour thing on a Saturday, and that was probably, two or three seasons ago, maybe even more.
And when you do make it, you're always like, I have to go.
And then I have to go. You know what? I just feel very, it's just a thing that I have. I just can't. When I'm indoors sitting at the computer and the kids are outside running around doing stuff when they expect me, I feel like I need to be out with them because that's the time I get to spend with them, the weekends and nights. So, but I mean, they would understand. It's not them. It's really me. Because, the one's going to college now and I'm like, dang, I wish we had spent more time together,
Yeah.
As much as I can't wait for the empty nest thing when I can just play video games all day long like I did when I was when I was 20.
We're going to know in like 6 years whenever your channel suddenly has like 6 videos a day.
Oh, man. I'm going to go through the roof with this stuff. Trust me.
Before we end up here, do you think you'll make it to Minecon this year in Europe?
In
with
Europe?
The whole family?
Is that where it is?
We
were so close to making Paris, but it kind of fell through at the end.
Yeah,
I know.
You only did one day last year, didn't you? Didn't you come last year for one day or something?
No, that was PAX.
Oh, right.
I met you guys at PAX, and then you did a panel with the Shaft, and then I had to leave.
That's right.
I said, "Hey,
Guude." 3 seconds. Hi, Paul.
And then right after that, when you ran to another panel, and I was like, all right, ready to go.
You do a panel with Joe Hill. Literally the same time that panel was ending. Right.
Yep. Yeah, it's just my life at this point. So I try to make the best of it.
Well, hopefully you can make Minecon. It'd be really cool if we get all the Minecrackers together for one convention at some point or another. I don't know if it'll ever happen.
I really want to. So I don't know if my whole family will go, but I would go because paying for college now this year and addition on the house, how things can go. So, but I would love to get out there and spend a week partying with the boys and the girls.
Thanks for joining me, Paul.
I love it, man.
You have the most unique statue, at least. You know, it's funny because everyone else was trying to be the tallest or whatever. You're just the wettest.
I'm just the wettest. I am definitely the wettest. That's my fame, my claim to fame here.
The bursting depends. Well, I hope everyone has enjoyed. Please leave us a comment if you have any suggestions on how this could be any better.
I don't know. That's a sign of perfection right there.
Yeah. This guy have a hard time topping this, I think. Thanks for watching, everybody.
All right, Guude. Thanks for having me. Thanks, guys. We'll see ya.
See ya.
Bye-bye.